Do you ever drive without shoes on?
What you mean?
Like, you know, driving, like you say you had to move your car or something and like you didn't have your shoes on, you go outside and you're barefoot driving?
Oh yeah, you're Fred Flintstone in it.
Yeah, I mean, it's always like so hard to control. You lose all the sensitivity, you're jerking around, you know? I was like, what would Jesus do? Was he always really wearing sandals?
I was always wondering if Jesus actually had good traction on water.
Yeah, I mean, you can walk on it, but can you run on it? Can you hike? I mean, you're not elevating, so it's a little different, right? It's not like you have to get traction and go up anything.
Yeah, pull.
He's just floating. So, I mean, do you have all the traction when you're running around there? I mean, I know for sure you can barefoot walk on water, you can walk on water, but I know for one thing's for sure, you cannot drive barefoot.
Yeah.
Is there a law against it? I mean, human law is different from the code of law that priests live under. So, I mean, are you really allowed? If you get pulled over and they check you for, like, DUI and you're not wearing shoes, they like, yup, you're going into jail right away?
Not really sure about that one.
And you never know, we're going to have an Exodus 20:15, John 8:44. We might have a Galatians 5:19-21. Came up on an Isaiah 40:29, and it was ridiculous. Had someone come up to me, and he was acting like a total Saint Anthony. Oh, there we go. Let's pull up on this.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Let's go figure out what's going on here.
Sometimes there's something, sometimes there's nothing. It's one of those times that it was nothing. The Lord knows that I'd like it that way.
Amen. So who would you rather? David, he's got a Goliath-sized serpent, or Bradley Cooper gives you a hand job, but he's got stigmata.
Pre-Abrahamic?
We got a possible C7 in progress. Male, 5'7", baseball cap, driving a blue BMW. Corinthians 13:14.
Pre-Abraham? No, we're gonna go modern era. You know, if you're going for it, go for the best. Or what you want.
Okay, what's that looking like?
Oh, he's on the left, make sure he doesn't get away.
Oh, shit.
Salim, what you doing on this part of town?
And you know I'm making my deliveries. Why are you guys always hassling me?
Hey, Kim, isn't your husband out of town in Decatur?
Call me!
Stop resisting!
Man, this job's crazy. You know, each of us, we all attend seminary. We've done the teachings and studies of the Lord while we were in school. And then some of us get hand-selected to be on patrol here, you know? So some of my colleagues that went to school with and Sant'Angelo's, what are they doing? They just got services on Sunday. They got to do some active contritions. But we get to do all the fun work, right? We've been hand-selected because we can make these quick decisions based on good and evil in the blink of an eye. We have no weapons, just the power of God and our free will to make good decisions. The only thing we carry on holy pistols, they're armed with holy water. And so all we can do is really bless evil and take a positive look. I still can't believe District 7 hockey, Mighty Ducks, they go on to win the league against this club team, the Hawks. And then afterwards they say, you know what, Gordon Bombay is the most amazing coach ever. We should just take his entire team. Dude, Averman on Team USA Hockey? Are you kidding me? I mean, he was hilarious for moral support, but come on. Connie and D? So they go to Goodwill Games, it's D2, they go to the Goodwill Games, and then somehow they sneak off, where are the chaperones? They make it all the way to South Central, where these white kids from Minneapolis are gonna go play against this pickup hockey roller derby thing on the roof. They end up knocking this puck off the roof, and this guy gets into his car and goes, "You kids!" Like, and then he just throws the puck back. Got you, motherfucker. And then you're going down in the third round.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Don't worry. I got this.
You wanted to see us?
Pretty standard little Saturday. We had a, you know, a few bumps.
Yeah. And what did that involve?
Reconciliation, confessions, you know, typical.
And doing baptism.
Priests do baptisms every day.
So I would imagine you know the difference between an illegal baptism and a regular baptism, an actual one under the house of God.
I mean, what are you talking about? I have no
what
idea what you're talking about.
Hello? Do you not see my screen? Do you see all those news reporters? Do you see that news right there? That's for you dumb bucks. That's because of you. The bishops, the cardinals, they want me to take your fucking collars. The Pope even wants me to take your collar. Well, what am I gonna tell them? Huh? I already lost Yama. I lost Plavik last week. They turned their collars in, so you're the only two I got. Here's what you gotta do. Tonight, you have an exorcism, District 6 at 2200. 16-year-old female. She's been infected for at least 2 days. Possible Ouija board incident. Do you understand what you're supposed to do? Where you're supposed to go? Good luck to God's feet. Get the fuck out of the house.
Father, everlasting God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who once and for all consigned that fallen tyrant to the flames of heaven, who sent your only begotten Son.
And one?
Wait.
That roaring lion, peace to our souls on heaven.
One. Two. Holy fuck, man. That was like way more than I expected.
When she started trying to puke on you, I was...
I didn't even know you could try to do that. Is that a thing? People try to do that? I know people spit. Dude, where's your pants? How are you have a shoe on and no pants? What the fuck? It's crazy.
Oh. Priest patrol. Holy shit.
God, show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down.
Jesus, walk with me,
Oh, can I get one of those cigarettes? You're always smoking one of those.
And cut. That was fucking awesome.
Yes, and arrest us. Saying we eat pieces of shit like you for breakfast, huh? Y'all eat pieces of shit. What's the basis? We ain't going nowhere but got suits and cases. A trunk full of...